to love international. Wherever you're going, wherever you're coming from, you either begin or end in love. Are you old enough to remember when flying was fun, travel was romantic, and flight attendants were part of the fantasy? Now flying is fatigue, travel is exhausting, and flight attendants are airborne irritants. But while it may no longer be romantic to fly, there are few places more filled with romance than an airport. Love we do and love we must, never forgetting that unrequited love, like unattended baggage, will be removed by airport personnel or replaced by the next unattached traveler. And don't forget, your baggage may have shifted during flight.
What can I get you fellas to drink?
Manhattan up, water back.
Just like you like it, Red Eye.
You're so good to me.
It's my job. It's what I get paid to do.
Oh, I thought you did it because I'm so sweet and wonderful and handsome.
Well, you thought wrong, Skywalker. I forgot. Where are you off to this time?
Portland.
When can I expect you back?
Thursday on the Red Eye. You'll be the first to know.
Well, don't wake me with the news. I got a job to do. And don't forget the tip.
I think relationships should be a lot easier than they ever wind up being.
Yeah, how come they never are, even when they're good?
I know you can't expect them to be perfect, but why can't love be easy, breezy,
beautiful? Why can't love be perfect?
I think we discovered what philosophers call a conundrum.
A what?
Not condom, Miss One Track Mind. Conundrum.
Oh,
as in predicament?
I knew that.
Hey, Ben, you see those two women over there?
What about them?
What do you say we offer to buy them a drink?
Because they already have drinks and they don't look especially friendly? Besides, they're probably married and probably be offended. Probably be offended whether they're married or not.
Nonsense. Women like the idea of men paying attention to them. What's the worst that could happen?
I could make a long list, beginning with us being humiliated, ending with their husband showing up.
You're such a pessimist. Come on, just follow my lead. Instead of just barging in on them, we'll be a little more circuitous. Take our time, you know, subtle, nuanced, suave, just dick suave. Can my friend and I buy you a drink?
No!
I'm not certain who I should feel more sorry for. Those women, or those poor men who have absolutely no clue what asses they've just made of themselves.
Hey ladies, can I get you two a drink?
No!
Well, you're in a good mood.
Just enjoying the latest episode of Adults Behaving Badly. Just coffee for me, Alex, I'm about to go on duty.
Same for me. As soon as she's airborne, I'm on to my next meeting.
Ah, Java for those with jobs. Coffee for Kate and the same for Sam.
So, what's on for the agenda when I get back? I got a few days off.
How about a few days at the lake? Weather's getting better. Even if it's not perfect, there's the fireplace, the woods, and me. No plans, no visitors, no schedule. Just see what the day brings.
Sounds perfect. Just make sure it brings something good to eat and drink.
Consider it done.
Choose the words so carefully, so that every one means more than love itself. With every touch and smile you share with me, time stands still, the place that only two in love can share.
When you're asleep, I think back to the day we met, and all I hear is your voice. When you say you love me, nothing matters or compares to how I feel in that moment.
I never knew how love could be until I've loved you. It's as if suddenly, my life has found its way.
When I'm away, close your eyes and listen to the sound of love. Love beats in our hearts. Then suddenly, magically, our love is there.
Flight 21A to Dallas will be boarding in 15 minutes.
Hey, Ben, you know what women and planes have in common? They're both difficult, unreliable, and expensive.
Women always have been, but it seems like flying wasn't all that bad years back.
First class women and first class seats. You pay more, but they're worth it.
You know, it seems everyone's trying to get the best deal for the least amount of effort in love and travel.
trying to book on Expedia or Orbitz. But life is not Expedia.com. You men want nonstop flights and low-cost romance. But most of the time, love has delays, cancellations, misconnections, and lots of choppy journeys, always changing planes and partners. Seems like love is just a series of endless hellos and goodbyes, journeys without destinations. We get on board hoping for a comfortable seat and a full-course meal. Instead, we get a lumpy cushion and a tiny bag of unsalted nuts. And, as you may have heard, our baggage no longer flies free.
You sure know what you're talking about, Miss Announcer Lady. I couldn't have said it nearly as well as you, which leads me to a confession I should make. I'm not only afraid of love, I'm scared as hell of flying, too. In fact, I'm so scared I have to get tipsy before takeoff. And to help ease the stress, I pretend each flight is a woman.
That's just too weird for me.
And way too much information for me.
Let them talk. You guys could probably deal with a big dose of honesty. Have you ever tried it, especially with a woman?
Before I fly, I just start drinking and thinking about women. It helps me calm my nerves. Then I give each flight a woman's name. I've christened today's Josette.
Josette? What good does that do, and what kind of name is Josette? Sounds like one of those ugly, nasty, yippy, 2-pound dogs women carry around in their purse.
I don't think I've ever felt this way before. I can't even say exactly how it's different, let alone describe the feeling. Kind of squishy, I guess. No, not squishy at all. Not squishy. Alive. Maybe more alive than I've been in my entire life. I kind of tingle. I meant tingling when I said squishy. I see and feel things I've never noticed before. I feel empowered. Oh crap, I can't believe I said that. I hate that kind of psycho babble, new agey blather. So self-serving and, well, squishy. I just need to go with it. I don't need to say the L word, but just might be, maybe could be, maybe will be.
Flight 17B to Savannah boarding shortly. Gate A12, Concourse A.
So where are you headed?
Near LA.
Nowhere is near LA, because there actually is no LA. It's just a bunch of places right next to each other pretending to be a city.
You could say that.
I just did, but I still don't know where you're going.
One of those places pretending to be LA.
What do you like to do there?
Whatever needs to be done when I get there.
Must be illegal.
What makes you say that?
You're being so evasive.
Not evasive, just chary.
Chary? Char-y? It's not like one of those, like, Valley Girl words. I don't even know what it means. Are you married?
Not recently. Not that it's any of your business.
You're very attractive.
Oh, thanks. Are you?
Attractive?
No, married. Be very careful with your final answer.
I wanted to let you know that we just got back. I'll be home about a half an hour later than I thought. Are you okay? How are the kids? Probably another ear infection. Do you want me to stop at the pharmacist and... Yeah, I know I wasn't too engaging when I left for the airport the other day. That bad? I'm sorry, I was in a hurry. Had a lot of things on my mind. I know, that's no excuse to be nasty and rude. Was I really that bad? Look, I know, you gotta go. See you in a few hours.
I keep calling, thinking he will answer. What's wrong with me? Nothing, other than I'm a stupid, ignorant fool and a foolishly out-of-date woman. Could anything be worse? I guess if I believed those how-to-get-rich selling real estate infomercials or the ones peddling some objects that will give you abs of steel. Who believes that stuff? Who buys that stuff? Of course, then there's me, who believes that when some guy tells me that he loves me and that he's coming to see me, and here I sit,
I'd be better off working on my abs of steel. He's not coming back. Never, ever. What part of that fact am I not understanding as I sit here calling, texting, pretending?
Oh, so, Valma, what's new in your life?
Ain't never nothing new. Same old recycled trash, same old mops spills to mop up, same old messes to clean up. Nothing folks do better than make messes. It's like the whole damned airport's a susceptible.
A receptacle?
Yeah, whatever. Big shots. They never see it. They just throw it because they know someone will come along and pick up after them. Never see me. Oh, they look at me. Ain't saying they don't. They never see me.
Well, that's because they're looking for their flight. Or better yet, special someone. If I've learned anything on this job, it's that people have a deep-seated desire to connect with another person, to finally fly first class and nonstop beside someone who really loves them. Well, they're looking for romance and adventure, something that lasts.
Longer than the crap they're always shoving in their mouth. Making mischief and leaving trash is what they do. Who wants to connect with that? Sometimes I think they're nothing but trash contemptibles themselves. Oh, sure, they got their air, sure enough. Poke him a good one in the belly like one of the Mexican sonatas.
Piñatas?
And nothing but a whole bunch of balled up empty wrappers come flying out. Another mess for me to clean up.
Damn, you're dark as a black hole today.
No reason not to be, as far as I can tell. Today, I saw a guy wearing a $500 satin warm-up suit that he ain't warmed up nothing in except his fat ass running for his flight. He was all duded out with neck chains and $300 running shoes. And but he used to run nowhere except his next connection. It was with one of them women that looked like they got a face.
Ass.
Yeah, and they got like a face with not enough skin left to cover it. It shrunk in the washer. Well, Mr. Usain Bolt just hands me a Starbucks cup, and the woman with the plumped up lips just drops her on the ground. Church going folks too, praying to God to clean up after him, I bet. He's nothing but invisible just like me. Damned hypochondriacs.
Hypocrites?
What about me having a dream? What about me flying first class and nonstop with someone who loves me? And a flicker of that goes through the geraniums.
Craniums.
To them, I'm just a crazy old lady that cleans up their messes. And they're just as fake as the cell phone wrappers they throw on the floor.
I'll see you later, Velma. For you.
Thank you. So that's that, Ted. We're over. Done? Turn off the lights. Close the door. See ya?
It's just not working. At all.
Maybe that's because you're not working at it. At all.
Love shouldn't be work.
No, you're right. Love shouldn't be work. But relationships sure are work, and you should love the work.
Look, I'm sorry. I just can't do this anymore. I quit.
To hell with you. You can't quit a job you never did. And besides, I fired you before you quit. You never worked at this a day in your life. You weren't qualified to do the job. Watch him. He's not who he says he is. His photo is real. Nothing else about him is.
You must have sat next to a snorer, a gabber, or a farter during your flight.
I wasn't even the one flying. I was left at the gate by pain.
As in the ass?
Precisely.
Well, at least the pain is now in the air and not in your ass.
I should never have gotten involved with that jerk.
You think maybe they're all born that way?
Maybe. But they sure do a good job in the beginning of imitating a silly prince.
Yeah, and you kiss them, and they turn into... No, the fairy tale's got it all wrong. Not frogs, but creeps.
Yeah. just feel like such dits.
Well, there are a lot of women that possess the same sort of kissing magic you do. Believe me, I've had my share of losers. Hate to think it was my kissing that did it.
Honey, I can tell you that I've been with some of the most worthless men you can ever imagine. Some I've never even kissed.
Yeah. I'm just so tired of living through relationship after relationship. Me, the one who's dumped all the time. You know what? It's not gonna happen again.
You are woman, hear you roar!
I am woman, hear me roar. In numbers too big to ignore. And I know too much to go back and pretend. Cause I've heard it all before, and I've been down there on the floor. No one's ever gonna keep me down again. Oh, yes, I'm wise, but it's wisdom for the pain. Yes, I paid the price, but look how much I gained. If I have to, I can do anything. I am strong.
This time?
Concourse B. Beyond that, I'll have to check my itinerary. 10 days in 3 different places. It makes no difference to me, they all look alike. I live in Clonesville. You got your same strip malls, car dealerships, fast food joints. It makes no difference. The only places I get to see are the interstates and conference rooms. Every place is the same place. Even those awful paintings. You got your sailboats, geometric shapes, your flowers. Who do you think even paints them? Why do they bolt them to the walls? Who in the world would want to steal those?
Oh, is Captain Kirk feeling sorry for himself?
Got to. No one else will. You sure won't.
I didn't know that was part of our current arrangement.
You're irrepressible.
And irreplaceable. Don't forget that, Top Gun.
One of the many things I love about you is your total indifference to sentimentality.
Oh, and all along, I thought it was my big teeth.
Your teeth aren't that big, but I like them just the way they are.
Will you still love them when they relocate?
I won't even notice.
Well, that's because you'll be senile and half blind by the time they do. In the unlikely event that you're even still around.
Well, I'd love to stay and have you whisper more sweet nothings in my ear, but I have to go to...
Already?
Yes, Concourse B.
Or to a heart condition at the pace you're going.
Oh, trust me. I have a heart condition already.
You know where to find me when you splash down. Bon voyage, Mr. Cruz. Uh-oh. I need to keep him off balance until the ground rules are firmly established. By me. Oh, but that man. He's gotten around the speed bumps and getting to me much faster than I'd like. This is getting dangerous, and it always comes to no good in the end. Oh, damn you, guy. If you wanted romance, why didn't you go someplace else?
It's another day at Love International. Airport romance. A chance encounter between two people on their way to somewhere else. A name and a number exchanged. Maybe, maybe not. A drink and the peck on the cheek, perhaps. One exits left, the other right. Concourse A, Concourse Z. He thinks about getting home. She thinks about getting away. 21st century love. It's flighty, it's insecure. It's frequently terminal. And sometimes, it's not only the bags that have shifted during flight. Oh, the way we carry on.
So, what'll be for you today?
Not sure. Maybe just a soft drink, or maybe nothing.
I want one for the sky, anyway. Couldn't hurt. Well, apparently you see something you like. Now, maybe my special courage cocktail is just the support you need. You know, say hello, strike up a bit of conversation. Who knows what might happen?
Oh, no. I'm not interested.
Everyone's interested. Sure looked to me like you were looking, too.
Well, I kinda was, but, you know, just looking at her, not looking for any, relationship or romance or anything like that.
You wanna know something? I think everyone is looking for a relationship, hoping for romance, looking for love. She was kinda checking you out.
She was not.
She was! I saw her looking at you, and I'll bet if you made the slightest effort to really look at her, she just might invite you to go over and sit next to her. Come on, give it a shot.
I'm interested.
Besides, isn't all love really just make-believe? Real love always begins as make-believe. If you can't and don't have anything to believe in, you're left with an old hairy fat guy in a stupid red suit. What kind of thing is that for big people to believe in?
Think I was a bit too forward?
Oh, the poor man was petrified.
Then why?
Be nice. Keep it clean.
I hope he gets on the right plane.
He might have to go to one of those diaper-changing stations first.
Oh, they have those in men's rooms now.
Lucky for that guy.
Going back to our conversation before the floor show.
Oh, yes. What were we talking about?
Relationships.
That's right. Oh, the romantic sort.
Are there others?
And you were saying?
It seems to me that when a woman tells a man she loves him because of who he is.
And he thinks she means it.
Well, that certainly is crucial.
But Houston, we still have a problem.
Which is?
When women fall in love with men, we always believe we can change them. You know, just improve them. Buff them up a bit. It's like it's gray raw material. And with most men, I mean very rough.
Oh, that's cold. But I don't think most guys are likely to change very much.
About as likely as the Bills win in the Super Bowl?
Listen to you with the football reference. You know what Jesus said to the Bills the last time he was on Earth?
No, what?
Don't do anything until I get back.
Believe me, I know. But we don't stay in our cheerleading skirts forever. We're like a fine, aging wine. We may gain a few pounds, but we also get knowledge, wisdom, experience.
And that is the problem. A double bind. Why can't just be two people who are exactly what the other one needs and wants?
But how many people actually know what they need and want?
Few, I guess. It just seems so hopeless.
I realize that, but also realistic. That's just the way it almost always is, unless it's a lasting love.
But how will you know?
You won't until you do.
British Airways Flight 278 is now boarding. Gate 17, Concourse B.
Sorry.
No, it's me. It's my fault. I'm always somewhere other than where I am and bumping into people.
That's pretty impressive, being in two places at once. You okay?
Yeah, fine, but I'm always bumping into people. Rude, and I need to quit doing it.
Well, I'm glad you did it before you bumped into me. I would have hated to have missed the opportunity to meet you.
Except you haven't met me.
That is true. I'm Frank.
I'm Sylvia.
Are you, or were you, by chance, Sylvia Carruthers?
I was once, and I am again.
I'm Frank Jenkinson.
Oh my God! Frank Jenkinson, it is you.
Are you okay? You look as if you've seen a ghost.
Well, I have.
It has been a long time.
And a lot of bumping into people and things. What are you doing here?
Oh, I was getting off a plane. I assume that's what you were doing.
Still a smart aleck, aren't you?
You used to think it was one of my more charming attributes.
Because there weren't many to choose from. Do you live here?
No, I actually don't live here in the airport, but I do in the city. And you?
I think I really do live in the airport. Did you happen to notice we're sort of in the way?
No. I was, too busy looking at you.
Well, stop looking at me and grab
Sorry.
Your bag.
Do you maybe have time for a drink? Or dinner?
As a matter of fact, I've got time for a drink. And then I'll decide if I have time for dinner.
Any place around here you like?
Yeah, follow me. I'll try not to bump into anyone.
I'd follow you anywhere.
Well, you seem to have made a wrong turn somewhere. I haven't seen or heard from you for, what, 15 years?
17.
Well, apparently you've been paying attention to something.
Yeah, and right now it's your wonderful...
Easy, Tiger!
Not another word.
What's new in your world, Alex?
Oh, with the hours I work, there isn't much in my world outside this place. Messes on the bar and at the bar. Good drunks. Bad drunks. Lonely men. Lonely women. Sad couples. Happy couples. Seems more of them sad than happy. Makes you appreciate the happy ones even more. People coming and going. People not knowing if they're coming or going.
Not a pretty picture you paint, girl. But there may be hope. Look at them. No matter who you love or how you love, we're all in the same boat. Alex, don't say it!
The love boat. You're so right. In so many ways, I didn't realize how much you have to pretend in order to make it work. If it's real, it's to have some pretend. Oh, Kate, it's just one paradox after another.
Maybe the secret to love and romance is turning contradiction into paradox and seeing the simple in the complex. How to be unequally equal.
It's beginning to sound like advanced algebra to me, but it's sure to work better than trying to turn frogs into princes by kissing them. You waiting for Samantha?
Oh, yes, they landed a little while ago, and she's off duty for 3 days before her next rotation.
Oh, 3 days? Good for you two. Any plans?
Just some nice quality pretend time, I hope.
Flight 162D is
canceled. Please see the company desk for alternate flight information.
You sure you turned off the coffee pot?
Well, it turns itself off.
I don't trust that. We're going to be gone 2 weeks. It could burn the whole house down.
Oh, it'll smell just like a Starbucks.
You're not funny, mister.
I'm not being funny. I like the way Starbucks smells. Better than the way it tastes.
What would you know about taste? Look at that outfit you've got on.
It's comfortable. Besides, we're going on vacation, not Project Runway.
It's hideous, Harold. Plaid stripes in the jarring colors, nothing coordinates.
Coordination, that's your job. And you're good at it, too.
Good thing, or you'd be a bigger mess than you already are.
Bigger than I am? Well, I didn't think you thought that was possible.
You're impossible. I don't know why I put up with all
of my what? Were you going to say a dirty word? That was close, wasn't it? You almost said a bad word.
Go to hell.
I'd really rather not. Arizona will be hot enough.
They wouldn't let you to hell with that outfit anyway. You look like a flag from some banana republic.
Well, in Arizona, I'll look just like a native.
But nowadays, you'll still probably need a green card.
He squeezes the toothpaste. That's all right. It's one of many things of great delight. But when he smiles and says it's not me, I just love him. And I know that he is perfect for me. If he just put the damn toilet seat down.
She stacks and piles stuff. It makes me nuts. Like every pile has some significance. The cats, they love piles, and so do I. That's how I know that I love her and that she's perfect for me. We're like peas in a pod. It makes us both seem a little odd. But unlike our friends, we won't complain. Our life's insane. Who we are.
He's always late home. That's his M.O. It makes me crazy waiting for him so. I know he works hard. I can't complain. I just love him, and I know that he is perfect for me.
And lately, she falls asleep, works all day, and then a house to keep. I try to help her the best I can. Does she know that I love her and that she's perfect for me? We're like peas in a pod.
Sorry. Where are you headed, Amy?
Houston.
Must be worse places, but I've never been to one.
I tend to think of Houston as a mistake, with great shopping.
That works for me. I like it. How's life?
Well, I'm officially single, so fairly uncomplicated. But I think I may be just sick enough that I want a little complication to offset the solitude, you know? Oh, breakups are such a bitch. Especially when we find out over Twitter.
Tweet, tweet, little birdie. You can count on men for anything, you can count on them for complication. They do tend to churn up a bit of a thunderstorm on an otherwise calm day.
Men provide us with a parade they can rain on. Men provide drama,
more like melodrama. You know, men are pretty good during the seduction and courting phase, but they tend to lack endurance and put on armor once the real work begins. But don't take anything I say too seriously.
Oh, fair enough. But I do take your drink mixing skills very seriously. What's that one you make with the numerous exotic ingredients? What's it called again?
Oh, one, will I respect myself in the morning? Coming right up.
Amy.
Oh, hey, Austin.
Looks like you're on the mend.
Well, Beyonce and I are survivors, Austin, and how are you?
Oh, you know how it goes. Everything seems so right, and then all of a sudden...
You're not in love anymore.
When it happens slowly, you tend to ignore it. Until you wake up one day and it smacks you in your stupid face and it hurts like hell.
I know all about it. You can't get to a certain age, which I think we both achieved.
That's a nice way to put it, achieved. But not really much of an achievement, is it?
Perhaps not, but nonetheless we've managed to get here, haven't we? And falling in and out of love a few times goes the territory, I guess.
Remember those music boxes when you were a kid that you cranked and it played Pop Goes the Weasel?
Forgotten all about those stupid things.
When it came to Pop, the top flew open and this crazed-looking clown, not a weasel, on a spring popped up and scared the hell out of you, and probably smacked you on the chin, too. It took my kid brother about 100 times before he realized he was the one causing the clown to smack him. But by then he'd actually grown to like it, and he would put his face down near the lid and laugh like a fool when the clown would smack his silly face. I thought he was the dumbest person I knew, until much later I realized he was just practicing falling in and out of love. That's kind of what we do. Turn the crank, play the music, get popped, shove the clown back in the box, start the whole process over again.
You know, that's closer to the truth than I'd like to admit.
But I still don't understand why my brother was laughing.
Maybe he was smarter than you and me put together, and maybe laughing is the only reasonable response. The stupidity of us always repeating the same old pattern.
You might be right. You ever been married?
A couple long-term relationships, but I've never been married. How long have you been married?
Almost 9 years. It gets tough with kids, jobs, traveling. It's just really difficult right now.
You think it can ever be any different?
I suppose so. I hope so, though I don't embrace that idea with much confidence.
So you don't think we can learn from experience?
I don't think I have. At least not yet, but I'm trying. You know, I can't decide if my brother was clueless or maybe just a masochist. I worry about both things with myself.
Well, I'm pretty sure I'm not a masochist, but I've sure been a clown a few times.
And you've probably smacked a few people in the puss more than once.
Can't deny that.
Do you date anyone now?
I've decided not to date for a while, but I may go out occasionally.
I'm not certain I get the difference.
Just think about it in terms of who's turning the crank on the clown in the music box. It's me.
Thanks for the talk. Have a great flight. Hopefully there won't be any clowns popping up.
There's always at least one. I hope you and your wife can get over the bumps.
So do I, Amy. So do I.
You know, you could pay a shrink or a marriage counselor a lot of money. And maybe never hear anything as insightful as that bit about clowns and music boxes and who's cranking who. I love this job. I learn something new every day. That beats the hell out of Dr. Phil's.
Aren't that old Jimmy Johnson someone else in that race?
He plain old seven period. Damn near of a race, even when it don't win.
Small work, don't he, though?
He don't seem like he needs to think much. He just does.
He don't need to think. Doesn't even need to does. He just do.
Damn if he don't. Yes, sir, if he ain't the president of the United States of NASCAR, then I sure don't know who is. He just gets it done.
That's for sure. Thanks. Wish I had me a woman that was a doer rather than a don'ter.
I know what you mean.
As far as I can tell, though, most women, they're a doer, is doing what they want to do, never what I want to do.
Got that about right. My woman always about doing rather than don'ting when it comes to me. She told me she don't want me to play softball no more.
Why the hell not?
She says softball's for single guys.
Tell her you ain't no single guy. You're a home run hitter.
She wouldn't understand that. And even if she did, she wouldn't think it was funny.
Well, ain't that something? Softball's for single guys. Didn't never see that in the rules nowhere.
In our house, she makes the rules. She's the umpire and the manager.
Does she sell the beer too?
No, she don't sell no beer. And she don't allow me to have none in the house, neither.
She's taken all the enjoyment out of life.
She sure is about has.
Well, maybe it ain't so bad. I mean, when you're getting used to not having anything, then when she up and leaves you, you won't have nothing for her to take. Because when they leave, it ain't no more about the doing, not doing, having, not having. It's all about the taking, more taking. Well, time to get back on the job.
See you around, Alex.
See you later.
Sure you don't want to switch to our team, Alex?
Hey, Sam. Your usual?
The usual. As usual.
It will be touching down immediately.
So, how was the flight?
Routine. So very boring.
You'd rather have drunks, crying babies, and maybe a terrorist or two? I worry about you.
I know you do. But your worrying doesn't shut the babies up or sober the drunks, and sure as hell doesn't protect me from the terrorists.
They now have bombs in their underpants, for God's sake.
Underpants, shoes, zippers, sinus cavities? Who in the hell knows where they're gonna put them next?
I'd rather not think about it.
Are you sure there's nothing the matter? I'm sure. I'm just completely exhausted.
You want another drink, Kate?
Maybe.
Maybe we should go someplace else.
Fine. But you wanted us to be normal, so we're having drinks in the airport. Everyone has drinks in the airport. We're just two normal gals, right?
You're right, but it just isn't working for me tonight. Come on, let's finish up.
Last call for flight 176A to Paris. Flight 176A, last call.
God, look at those two. Just when you think there's no hope, people bump into their past and discover what they've given up for lost, like the second sock in the dryer. And on their way to baggage claim, a safe landing. Lost baggage found. I think I'll treat myself to a true love cocktail. A cup of tenacity, a shot of patience, a dash of serendipity should do it. Can't forget at least a touch of bitters. Oh no, can't forget that. Mix, mull, don't stir, don't shake. Just wait. Be very patient and bump into it.
I'll take one of those. Make it a double if it means you do the hip thing twice.
I do the hip thing twice and you'll be drooling all over yourself. Aren't you a day early, Red Eye?
Finished a day early and made an earlier flight, but I'll be leaving again tonight.
Easy come, easy go. It's a good thing you could stop by for a drink at least.
Because you make the best drinks in town. You're the sweet vermouth of life, the cognac of dreams, the single malt of desire.
Now you got a line of crap longer than the security checkpoint on the Wednesday before Thanksgiving. But you got some style. I'll say that for you.
Nah, babe. You got all the style. I just got good taste.
Well, that kind of talk might get you somewhere. Even though you smell like the inside of a 727 that's been on a holding pattern for 3 hours.
Holding patterns. Sounds good to me. Well, I better get going.
When will Flyboy be coming back?
I won't. I've taken a new job offer, and I'm leaving for training tonight. It's a great opportunity, Alex. I can't pass it up.
Apparently, I was an opportunity you could pass up.
I will really miss you.
I sure would hope so. Women like me just don't show up in every gin joint along the way.
I mean it. I really will miss you. Who knows? One day I may be stopping back through and come to my favorite waterhole to get the best drink I've ever had. The greatest bartender I've ever known. You take care of yourself, Alex. You're just looking at you, kid.
That is the worst impression of Bogey ever. Now get out of here. Okay, folks, this is last call. That's for sure. Another last call. Another flight canceled. There's always another flight. Another Mickey Mouse to amuse me. Another character stepping up to the bar. And the damn bar isn't very high.
Hey, beautiful. Got time for just one more drink?
Depends on where you want to have it. I've already made last call.
Aw, come on. I'm a tired, thirsty traveler a long way from home.
And not dealing with it like the big boy you are. What'll it be for you today?
Bourbon on the rocks. You know, I fly in and out of this airport all the time and just now found this bar.
Oh, swell. Can my luck be any worse tonight?
What did you say?
Call or well?
Well is fine. Where have you been hiding?
Hiding? Bob, this bar is right in the middle of the airport terminal. And I'm right in the middle of the bar. How could you miss it? Or me?
Damned if I know. Jet lag, I guess. I'm always hoping to find a bar where they know what I drink when I sit down. Just a little touch of home.
Hey, you don't need a bartender. You need a mother. And a bar is always a long way from home.
This is as close to home as I ever seem to get. And you're much better looking than my mother. What's your name?
What'd I tell you? If it isn't Mickey, then it's Dopey. And there's always another flight. Fly me!
For all international and domestic flights, this is final boarding call.
In my heart, I feel it. One wish, one dream. It's my time now. See me. Hear me. It's my turn. Starstruck? Oh, maybe just a little. Deep breath, head high. It's now, and my heart is pounding. Trust me, there's no more scheming. Hey, right now is mine for the making. So stand back. My hands are trembling. Right now, I believe dreams can come true. Pinch me, am I dreaming? This time, they are waiting for me. Feel the light around me. I hear the crowds around me. This is mine for the taking. Alex is ready when you are.